So when I picked this book up, and the first line was, "In our family, there is no clear line between religion and fly fishing." I thought, wow. So I turned to the last line. The last line was, "I am haunted by waters." And that was it. Then I read the book and I thought, I have to make this film. I was told that the author, Norman MacLean, was an extremely difficult, tough guy who never wanted to see this book leave the fact that it was a book. He did not want to see it go to television or film. He was adamant, and he was a tough, tough guy. He was a teacher at the University of Chicago. So I decided I'm going to go try to do this. So I went to meet with him, and he said, you know, I don't want this made into a film. And I said, I understand that, and I'd like to try to convince you to let me make it. So we argued back and forth, and he pushed against me, and I pushed against him. Finally, I said, I took kind of a fairy tale approach. I said, I tell you what, I'll make a deal with you. I'll come see you three times, and I will come tell you why I would like to make the film and why the film should be made, and you can tell me why you don't think it should be made. And we'll argue, and we'll chat, and so forth, and then I'll go away. If we're still talking, I'll come back a second time, and I'll push again, and you'll push back on me, and we'll get into our tug of war, and I'll leave. And I'll give you 2 weeks in between each meeting to think it over, if you won't even see me again. So he said, okay, come back. I went back a third time, and we argued and argued and argued. And finally I said, okay, here's the deal. I'm done. I want to make the film, and it's your call. He said, okay, go ahead. So then it took me 2 years to get a screenplay. And I couldn't figure out why I was having such a hard time getting a screenplay of this wonderful book. And Richard Friedenberg, the writer that I hired to do the screenplay, was really having a struggle, because what he was doing was just focusing on the characters. The brother, Paul, who was this golden boy with a dark side, Norman himself as a young brother, their father, who was a preacher. And so he was trying to embody the characters, but nothing was coming out. It was flat, it was dull. I thought, well, what? I couldn't figure out why this was to happen. So then I looked at it and I suddenly realized, wait a minute. What the power of this book is the narrator, Norman MacLean. It's his words describing the family. It's his words describing his brother. His words describing the beauty of fly fishing. That's the real power of the book. So I said to Richard Friedenberg, I said, hey, you know, we're missing the boat here. What we need to create a narrator. We're gonna have to create a character that I'd like to open the film and end the film with, like a very old man who's coming out, getting his equipment together to fish. But he's very old. When he gets to the edge of the water, I'm gonna have his memory start to cook in. And his memory will be the words of Norman, who wrote it. That's how we solved the problem. And so we did it, we made the film. And the sad thing was, he finally let me make the film. And he said, I'm not gonna stand in your way, it's yours. But then he died before I could show him the film, so I'm kind of sad about that. Anyway, having said that, you all, it's late. I don't want to keep you waiting too long. But that's the story about how this film came to be. And for me, it was very, very personal. And so therefore, as we cut to where we are now, the idea that Brian Wimmer, who was born and bred here, has his own unit for fly fishing, and that we could bring that forward and have that be a big part of Sundance, is for me a thrill. Anyway, having said that, I hope you enjoy the film. Thank you.